Today, we shall be looking at the plot of Der Rosenkavalier, an opera by Richard Strauss. The plot is complex, convoluted even, with many plot twists, which I shall painstakingly elucidate in the next hour. We begin with the wealthy lady known as the Marschallin
and her young lover.
The noble lady Marschallin is partial to Octavian, though he's her junior by some years. Still, they make out like buccaneers. Act one, we find the pair in bed. Now, at this point, it should be said,
before my head begins to twirl,
Octavian's played by a girl. While they're canoodling, someone knocks. A wealthy, oafish boor named Ox. Octavian legs it in a trice. Ox wants the Marschallin's advice on how to woo a rich young thing named Sophie. While he's blathering, Octavian has reappeared, dressed as a maid. Now, that's not weird. A pretty maid, Marianne. Now Ox fancies her as well.
Why air the gender confusion?
Mind?
We would do well to give equal consideration to the matter of class and the prevailing contemporaneous society. Wow.
Ox is ready to propose to Sophie with a silver rose, which says he means to marry her. The old tradition around here is to send a young rose carrier, a Rosenkavalier. The Marschallin says, never fear.
I have your Rosenkavalier. I happen to have his portrait. Here,
a strapping lad, dashing blade, strangely similar to your maid, says Ox.
And now the chair purrs over Mariandel, poor girl, poor boy, poor girl. Act two finds Sophie very upset, awaiting a groom she's never met. Then who should suddenly appear but her Rosenkavalier, Octavian, and to her joy, she loves this boy. No, girl, no, boy! The feeling is reciprocated. They sing about it for a while, and when they're at their most elated, Ox shows up uncouth and vile, and volatile as rocket fuel, Octavian demands a duel. Thrust, parry, parry, thrust. Ox is wounded, but only just. Sophie's father, with a roar, shows Octavian the door.
Sophie, do as I tell you to, or it's the nunnery for you.
Now, Ox is even happier still. A note! It comes from Marianne! Now lusty thoughts pitch him to swirl as he pictures that sweet girl. Boy! Girl! Act three! And Ox is unaware Octavian has set the snare. Dressed up again as Marianne, will soon have Ox beneath her spell. His spell. Her spell. Never mind! Ox arrives, only to find maid's alluring radiance a bit too like Octavian's. There are more hard knocks awaiting. Ox thinks he's hallucinating when a co-conspirator, Penina, causes quite a stir, claims she's Ox's abandoned wife. Police arrive to quell the strife. Sophie's father wanders in, and now here comes the Marschallin, who sends everyone away, including Ox, in disarray. Now Octavian stands between his darling Sophie and the Marschallin. Who loves whom? And who dumps whom? The older lady reads the room and leaves the youngsters to their joy. A simple tale of girl meets boy. No girl. No boy.